Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is Screw Cage 2. And as you can guess from the name, it's a new variation of the Screw Cage puzzle, which I've shown you before. And the Screw Cage puzzle, there are many things that I don't like about it. So, for instance, if you accidentally pick it up, it already falls apart, which is not a good feature. If you would hide something inside the cage, it's not a good hiding place because it immediately falls apart. And also, putting it back together, even though it's now in its soft state, putting it back together takes a lot of dexterity to get everything right. So even though it is functional as a puzzle, I consider it a failed design. So here is my improved version. First of all, what you see, there is a ball inside. So it has a goal, obviously, remove the ball. And the removal of the ball is not trivial, but it's not obvious as well, because if you try, everything is tightly together, fits tightly together. So one trick that you can do is, you see the screwed poles, is you can rotate the pole. But even with one pole down, you can't take it out. And you need to move all the four poles down. So, five of them, five rainbow colors. And when you have them all down, let's see, last one out. There we are, and we have the roof off. So now we have done the first part of the solution, but actually the whole the challenge of this puzzle is to take it apart completely and put it back together again. So another improvement that I've done is I've given the five poles all different colors, so I can distinguish them. Because, they have a pentagonal cross-section. Each of them is different, and they are all the five principal ways how you can make them. So the way that you solve this puzzle is, if you do it through trial and error, you just put the pieces in. And this is now completely randomly. They go through. And by the way, if you put them in the wrong orientation, they don't go in. So you really need to check, because at the bottom you see these this shape, and only if you put them in the right direction, they go all the way through. So, this one is a bit tight apparently. Anyway, when you have then placed the poles, the next challenge is to see whether they are in the right position and orientation. So each of them can be placed at five different places, so there's a lot of permutations. And also the roof, it can be in this direction, or it can be upside down, multiplied by five. So in theory, the number of attempts that you need to make to put this together is quite a lot. And obviously, if you think about it in a more clever way, so not just randomly trying, but looking what you're doing, actually the puzzle turns out to be quite solvable. So I'm really satisfied on how things stay together, and also when you put it together and click these poles in place, it's a very satisfying solving experience. So, the reason that I've been building this is to make it commercially more attractive. And that is also my question to you. Have I succeeded in making this commercially more attractive? And would you buy this puzzle if you would see it in a shop? Thank you for watching.